We've seen Neela Samandar in Daudi, aur usse pehle bhi. Then we've seen Huni Samandar. And everything Devara part one is all about is between these two things, right? It's like you've covered the entire spectrum. What is Devara for you and what is happening here? Tell us.
Devara for me, obviously, you know, it's not only a film, but it's a journey with Korotal Shiva for many years. I mean, we've known each other since this movie of mine called Brindavanam. Yes. And Shiva was the writer for the movie. And it was this growth of friendship between me and him. And then when he started off as a filmmaker, my interest towards him, my respect towards him has only increased with every film he's done. But I mean, it was very tough for him to sustain that kind of blockbusters which he's delivered.
Right.
It's only because Shiva has nothing in mind but the story of the film. It keeps running in his head. He just needs the right space. He just needs the right people around him to just excel in it. And when our journey started, right before RRR released, so he came up with this idea of this protagonist. Usually in commercial mainstream movie, we have a protagonist coming from the downtrodden, you know, when there's absolute zero courage, the protagonist comes forward, gives courage to the people who needs, you know, who needs courage, takes them and goes forward. But here there's a flip to Devara. So when courage is completely, you know, when it's filled to the brim, when it exceeds, there needs to be a certain amount of fear. And the protagonist is actually trying to give in fear than actually give in courage. So that for me, was a phenomenal idea. And then we started our journey of Devara. And here I hope we've lived up to the expectations of the trailer. And that's about it.
You know, whatever we've seen up till now is phenomenal. Right? As I said, we are like full of that intensity, that angst. It's in all of us. Talk to us about these action sequences.
Devara is, I've been, you know, when Karan sir and Apurva sir and Anil sir, the three mascots of Devara, the three musketeers as well, when they stepped in, you know, Shiva, when he narrated the script to them, and when they saw a few visuals of the movie, I mean, I was really shocked seeing their reactions. I mean, and that's when I came to know that, you know, this movie will definitely work. This movie is, I would call it an action drama. It is extremely high on action.
Right.
I mean, Saif sir would definitely agree with me. There were some physically strenuous action sequence we both have been part of.
Right.
It is definitely high on action. Peter Hines, then we had Anil Arasu, and then especially we had Solomon, who's worked for RRR as well, the National Award winner. He has actually extensively worked on the overwater and the underwater sequences of Devara. And we've shot for about 38 odd days underwater and about close to 60 odd days over water. So that itself was a chunk of 100 days to 80 to 100 days. So it is phenomenal action you probably haven't seen before. And the kind of water interactions, the kind of CGIs we've blended into those action sequences are phenomenal. So Devara is very high on action. And I would just can't wait for the world to see it.
I'm sure, sir, we're going to love it. Ekbar, zordar taliyan for this amazing team, ladies and gentlemen. The first Telugu film that you presented was Bahubali. It was a smashed, super duper hit. It was a blockbuster in the Hindi belt. What are your expectations from Devara Part 1?
I was, of course, as I said, that, you know, I was absolutely honored even then, you know, to present S.S. Rajamouli sir's vision. And, you know, kind of that began a massive journey, you know, for Indian cinema. I think Bahubali will always be the very first pillar, you know, that kind of held Pan-India cinema together, will always be a reference for so much. I have mega expectations of Devara, and for various reasons. The fact that this is, as Tarak himself said, his solo release after so many years, his fans have been waiting for this to happen. The fact that Saif and Janvi are part of this film, making it a true blue Pan-India experience. The fact that Siva sir's vision, you know, as a filmmaker is so exceptional. I don't want to put a number because that would dilute and demean what Devara means to all of us as a cinematic experience. But rest assured, it's going to be a celebration on the 27th of September.
Absolutely, sir. Fingers crossed. Of course, the celebration has already begun. As I said, in North America, we're doing so well already, even before the trailer. Of course, it is.
That itself is an indication, right? Because that's the first place where the advances have really opened. Yeah. And the fact that there is this just organically crazy, like madness, you know that that is an indication of the advances as well as the opening for the film across the nation as well.
Absolutely, absolutely. Thank you, Karan sir, for sharing that. Of course, Siva sir, this one's for you. Simran Sethi from ANI would want to know that what was your vision like before you started Devara, and did it alter a little while the movie was being made, or is it the same?
As I keep on saying that, this is the most ambitious film ever made from my side, not in terms of scale, but in the idea itself. Because the idea of the protagonist being the fear,
right,
is very exciting to me. And it remained the same throughout. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Saif, sir, this one's for you. Bharti ma'am, Bharti Dubeji would want to know, how do you look at this trend of cross-pollination of stars from North and South?
I think it's great, obviously, you know. I mean, we've gotten used to an idea where, you know, there's Bollywood and there's movies made in the North and there's movies in the South. And there's so many different movie industries in India. And the idea to have one film that can bring, you know, actors from different states like that together to create something that's truly Pan-Indian is becoming the new standard today.
Right.
Films have done it, and I'm sure films will continue to do it. I'm just really lucky that I managed to speak a bit of Telugu properly, because it seems to be the language also of the future, and to learn a couple more languages, and everyone needs to broaden their horizons, get out of their comfort zones as actors. And I mean, for me, it was a great, great honor to be part of this, and I'm sure it's going to be the future for a lot of people, you know, so it's great.
Okay, so we have a set of these questions that I've got from our friends from the media. So I'm going to be asking those questions, sir, on their behalf, that I want to present to the world. They were a part one.
It was nothing. He had me at hello. That's just the way. I mean, Tarak calls and you do what he wants. It's just the way it is. And, you know, we not just a fan as an actor, but so much respect for his trajectory, so much respect for Siva sir and, you know, everything that he has achieved in cinema. The combination of the both of them coming together, after they've made one blockbuster together and this is heading towards being a mega blockbuster. The fact that Saif was in the film, Janvi, I mean, it was like for us at Dharma Productions and AA Films, it was really an absolute no-brainer. To have our names associated with this magnificent piece of cinema that you just witnessed.
You know, we have to say that this trio, of course, Apoorva sir, Anil sir and you should and you are getting the credit for, you know, introducing us to this pan-Indian thing. Of course, we've had movies earlier, but Bahubali ke baad it all started. What do you think is that one thing or the one USP of Devara that it's going to appeal to all the people globally?
Well, you've had all the magic and madness on land, but have you seen it on sea? It's a first. I mean, when you see what they call like the blood sea, and you see all the action that happens, you know, on the water and the way, like there are sequences that are just sometimes you feel that you have a wild imagination and those can never really be fructified. But this has, like, you know, Siva sir had that imagination and then it was absolutely like executed to precision. So I think the big USP, I would say, is just the landscape of the film. The fact that water is such a star as well, and everything that happens in and around that arena really makes Devara like a standout film, and clutter breaks every other massive dramatic action film you've seen in Indian cinema.
Absolutely, sir. We'll get to see this on the 27th and we can't wait to watch it now. Shiva, sir, welcome to Mumbai.
Thank you.
How does it feel to be here, first of all, and of course, the amazing response that we've just gotten?
Firstly, thank you everyone for being here. And, a little bit tense, like this is my debut film. And, I hope everyone likes the film as much as we like. Thank you.
Sir, despite being this larger-than-life superstar, what do you think is that one quality that makes this gentleman here, Tarak sir, the man of masses, so humble? How come he's so humble, you know, despite all that stardom, that persona?
Even I'm trying to find out, actually.
So directing him, you know, directing him yet again after Janta Garaj, talk to us about that. Could change his eye, sir? You have to give us some masala, you have to give us something.
It's because, you know, he's a very close friend of mine, and once he's in front of the camera, I feel that, I don't know why, suddenly he changes his persona and he looks wild, actually.
Right.
Every time, for every shot, you know, I just keep staring at him.
Right, yeah. Right. So after watching Dawoodi, I had a title or a tag for the gorgeous and the very talented Janhvi Kapoor. Of course, I sat on it for quite some time and she had to leave. She had a flight to catch. But of course, the expression queen of the Indian film industry. You've brought that out, you know, from Janhvi. And her chemistry with this gentleman, Tarak Bhai here, it is phenomenal. People are saying, Jodiyan Karan sir banate the. Abhi, you've taken it to some other level. What do you have to say, sir?
Yeah, because they look too good on screen. And down south, people feel that after NTR sir and Sridevi, now it's this NTR and Janhvi.
Wow, you've said it, sir. You've said it. And Bhaira, we have to talk about Bhaira, sir. As I said, you know, the handsome, the ever so charming Saif Ali Khan, the brilliant actor. And here he's so ruthless, sir. Why would you do that to this man here?
No, even for the first time, I'm seeing him like this because I never saw him like this in Hyderabad.
Okay.
Because he comes to the shot, I see only Bhaira, and now he's looking like a rock star. He's something new to me now.
Thank you so much for sharing all of that. And thank you so much for this amazing piece of art, Shiva, sir.
Thank you.
Saif, sir, this one's for you. You know, you've portrayed these dark and complex characters earlier. And as I said, everything that we've seen from you on that big screen has been awesomeness. Here, how is Bhaira different? Or should I say, what were those distinct qualities or the unqualities in Bhaira that you said, yes, I want to do this?
Well, firstly, I was really excited, like I said, to get offered a big movie made, you know, from Andhra,
yeah,
and from the South industry that's given us so many incredible movies. And I think the future is going to be collaborations between North and South. And I think of it in terms of a pan-Indian kind of scenario.
Yeah.
Anyway, this role, I was very happy that Tarek ji wanted me in it. And Shivasa wanted me in it. I think they'd seen Omkara and remembered it. And I have to thank Vishal ji for that still.
Right.
It was a very interesting character because, you know, there's a young version, there's an older version, there's crazy makeup. And also, I wouldn't, you know, it's more of an anti-hero than a straight antagonist. And there's many layers to it. And it was just absolutely lovely doing it.
Right.
It's like an entry, a debut into a new kind of cinema.
Right.
And, you know, according to me, the cutting edge of Indian cinema right now. So it's great for me to be here.
Well, he said it, ladies and gentlemen, he said it. You know, talking about the man of masses, of course, the world is talking about him. Aur ab se nahin, kab se. So how was it collaborating with him?
And it was amazing. I mean, we met and we had a laugh from day one. He's a very easygoing person who wears his stardom lightly, which I like. And offset, a very, very friendly, welcoming person. We had a laugh from the first day, and he visited me in my van while I was waiting for a shot and made me feel so comfortable.
Right.
And we had a lovely laugh. He's invited me to his home and offered to cook food. And he's one of the most hospitable people I've worked with, a really, really nice, down-to-earth guy. But when the camera's on and when I saw him shooting on the set, he seems to grow in stature in front of the camera and becomes a larger-than-life person, which is a very great star quality to have. And when it's cut, He's back to being a normal, fun person. So I think he's been great, and it's been so nice working with him. He was also very patient because it's a new language for me.
Right.
And he was so supportive. Looking into his eyes and saying dialogues to him never made me feel anything except confident. Thank you.
Congratulations for your action-packed performance in Devara Part 1. Can you give us a sneak peek into any particular intense fight sequence or say a stunt that you're really excited for?
Well, Amar ji, right? Amar, do we have here? Do we have Amar ji here? Okay. So, oh, hi. Great. So, I can't point out on one such particular action sequence, or I definitely would not point out on one stunt or a sequence. But I'm sure Anil sir, Apurva sir, and Karan sir will agree with me. I think the last half an hour or 40 minutes of Devara is going to rock you all. So I can't wait. I just can't wait for people to watch that, the visual what my director Shiva had in his mind. And I just can't wait for the world to see it. that's
and you're riding that giant fish. Talk to us about
a shark.
That
was a shark.
The shark?
Yes.
So how was it like?
No, I mean, like, you should tell me. How was that? How did it look?
We loved it. I mean, loved that scene.
Well, I didn't. I hated shooting for it. I mean, that was one of the sequences which really took a lot of time.
You're giving us masala.
Oh, seriously. I was in a 200 by 150 tank, which was about 5.5 feet. And that shot literally took like almost a full day to get it right. So there's...
But
there's
it is marvelous. Whatever we saw there, you know, it is like amazing. Give it up for NTR Junior, ladies and gentlemen. Karan sir, you know, that's all with the questions from our friends from the media. But I have a question for you. Of course, you are this ace filmmaker, the creative genius. What is it that, you know, that appeals to you when you watch a trailer? Because we do this day in, day out. But, you know, I can see that twinkle in your eye today. It's something special. What is it that appeals to you the most when we release a trailer like this, whether you are a part of that film or not, as a cine lover?
As you just said, as a cine lover, as a cine goer, for me, I've grown up watching films in single screens. Like when I was 4 years old is when I went and watched a film in a single screen with my parents. And then that began my journey with watching massive cinema in cinema halls. So to me, every time I see a tentpole film, a cinema spectacle, it just makes my heart happy. Because this is what we are here for, right?
Absolutely.
We are here. What else we here for, as Kapil Dev says? We really like want to just like watch the magic of celluloid, just the magic of big mainstream cinema. So when I see a trailer like the Devara trailer, it just explodes. Like whether I'm associated with the film or not is really immaterial. I, as a cinegoer, as an audience, as a fan, when I watch massive entertainment, that's all I'm here for. That's all I want. That's all I live for, literally.
Absolutely. Tarak Bhai, this one last question for you. What do you have to say to all your fans now when I'm sure they must have seen the trailer? Ab kya bolna hai? Ek aakhri cheez.
I always want to thank them for all the love and all the support they've given me over the years of being an actor. And I don't know. I mean, there's a lot. There's a lot I need to thank them for. But I would just humble thanks. Thank you for being there with me.
Saif sir, closing remarks, I would say. What do you have to say to all the fans out there who were like eagerly waiting for the trailer and now it's out?
I think it's an amazing trailer. The background music, the visuals. I have to say, Randy sir, our DOP, has shot this film outstandingly. The cast has been fab. Of course, Tarak sir, Shivas's vision. I think it's really exciting. And like Karan said, you know, like a big movie coming out that you should watch in the theatres with all these beautiful colours and this amazing sound. I'm very excited.
As Saif sir just talked about the BGM and the dialogue, so that is something that was, you know, out there. The dialogues and the BGM complementing each other. Talk to us about that quickly, sir, please.
Right from the beginning, we thought of Anirudh as a music director because, you know, he's the master of sound and he knows how to blend the music into the story well. And happy that he gave this output. Yeah.
And it's going like with the dialogues, Tarak sir, one last thing. Talk to us about Shiva sir. Is he like always this like?
Have you seen him answer your questions? It's always.
That's what I'm saying.
It's like that long.
I was afraid.
So Shiva is a master in especially when in dialogues. You know, if your dialogue needs to be so much for you to like, let's say a kilometer, for you to like express your angst or whatever it is, to express something. Shiva's dialogues are just 200 meters.
Right.
They're just 200 meters. Right. So, and I don't know how he does it. He's extremely talented. I mean, I told you, I've been his friend for a very long time. We've been friends for a very long time. He just delivers the same expression in 200 meters. So it's like very few words, but the expression is so deep.
Precise and to the point, right? To the point. 27th September is when we'll get to see the movie in theaters. Let's just come to that point. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for a final photo op, and I'd like to invite on stage some really cool people. Ji. Main kar lu pehle? Aate hai na? Would like to invite on stage our very, very favorite people, of course, as I said, bade, in logon ne bada kaam kiya hai for the Indian film industry. Apurv Mehta Saab, the CEO Dharma, say give it up for him. And of course, he's presented it, he's distributed it. AA Film say Anil Thadani Saab, ladies and gentlemen. Anil sir, I know, you always say no for this. And I always say that I have a question for you. Anil. Cool. Ek second, aa raha
hu. We check the mics.
All right. Anil sir, quickly. You know, if you have to, as I said, the trio has worked wonders for the Indian film industry. Bahubali se ab tak. And of course, AA Films has been there. Wo logo aata hai, bahut maine rakhti hai baat. So please talk to us about Devara Part 1 and being a part of this collaboration one more time.
Just like to thank Tarak for showing and Shiva sir for showing so much confidence in Karan, Apurva and me. We've come back again to present this film after Bahubali and hope it just repeats the same kind of magic.
Yes, sir. We sure. Apurva sir, what would you like to share with us, please?
Again, I'll have
So, you know, we've always been huge fans of Tarak's work, be it in RRR or Temper or Janta Garage. So, really, thank you for giving us this opportunity. We were, like he rightly said, blown away when we saw the visuals. And I think everyone can understand what we are feeling once you see the trailer. So, thank you for trusting us, Tarak and Shiva sir, with your film. And we are so excited. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Karan sir, one more time, thank you so much for getting this to this part of the country. And of course, the movie releases on the 27th September, ladies and gentlemen, worldwide. And in the meantime, of course, yeah, it's time to go click, click, click. It's time for a final photo op. Ji.